Hi, I'm Dr. Jean Kornstrom. I'm the Director of Teacher Education in the Education Department here at Sol Ross State University. And I would really like to invite all of you to think about a career in teaching. Right now we're in a classroom, and most people do spend at least 13 years of their life in a classroom as a student. And I'm encouraging all of you to think about spending time in a classroom as a teacher. There are a number of rewards for being a teacher that are unsurpassed. If you like to work with people, teaching is certainly a career you should think about. You make connections with students and their families, and you help the students to acquire the skills so that they can achieve their dreams and goals, and that's very awesome. You make connections with people throughout their lives. In addition to if you like to work with people, if you love your content, if you came to Sol Ross because you love biology or you love history, you can pursue your subject area and then add on your teaching courses so that you can not only become an expert in your area, but you can also teach it. And what is more wonderful than getting paid an annual salary to learn more and more all the time about your subject area? Another reason to think about teaching is that oftentimes it is a full employment career, a full employment field, in that in Texas alone, according to the 2014-15 data, there were over 350,000 teachers that were needed in the public schools. So there always will be a demand for teaching. So these are some of the things to think about. As far as how do you become a teacher, you really pursue your first 2 years at the university before you make a commitment to education. In your junior year, if you decide to become a teacher, you do apply for the teacher education program, and then we have a program that really prepares you to be a successful teacher. We have two series of classes, a block one series where you learn learning theory, and in our block two you learn methods and materials for teaching. So you get a lot of coursework that will give you a background for teaching. You also get some experience in those classes in teaching in classrooms and doing a lot of observation in classrooms. We want to be sure that teaching is a career you really want, and for that reason we do require that you spend 30 hours or more of observation in classrooms in this area so that you really know this is something for me. After you complete all of the coursework, then we give you a student teaching experience for 14 weeks. And during that time, you work with a cooperating teacher, and you also have a university supervisor, and those people support you as you are teaching and learning how to maintain classes for a full day. So that's the second stage. The third stage to get your teaching credential is passing several state-required tests, and again, your coursework and experience as a student teacher prepares you for that. So as you're beginning your career at Sol Ross and starting to think also, what am I going to do when I graduate, I would really encourage you to consider teaching, as it is a very, very rewarding career.
I think the hardest part for me was that high schoolers nowadays, they use technology like crazy. And they feel that anything that's taught in the classroom is irrelevant because they can just look it up on their phones. So the most challenging part for me was trying to make history fun. Because as a whole, history is not fun. It is boring. So every day pretty much was a challenge because I was like, okay, what can I do to make these kids learn, have it stick, have it be fun to them? So I was coming up with activities for them to do instead of just putting notes on a projector and having them writing down and then testing them on it. So that was really challenging, how to make it fun.
My biggest challenge was time management with my lessons. I had the hardest time. There would be some lessons where I anticipated 30 minutes and then before I knew it, it was already an hour. And so my teacher would be like, okay, we need to move on to, you know, social studies, whatever it may be. And then there were some lessons where I thought it was going to take 45 minutes and then 15 minutes later I was like, all right, I'm done. So, time management was definitely hard to, you know, apply to the classroom, but I learned to get better at it. So.
For me, I guess one of the initial hardships I, you know, came across was waking up in the morning. I'm here at Alpine Middle School, and it's towards the end of town, but I still have to wake up at 6:15 in the morning and, you know, get everything ready. So that right initially I was like, oh my god. So that right there. And another one was with the lower grade, fifth grade, I had a really tough time with questioning. Like I was questioning their understanding and kind of tying it into their daily lives. And I hadn't been a fifth grader in like forever ago. So just really checking for understanding and, you know, really applying that knowledge that I'm teaching them to their daily lives. Like, you know, you're driving with your mom, you know, going to school and she slams the brakes. You know, that's inertia. You know, it's so tough to just tie it into that, so.
When they get it, when you just see it click and they're enjoying the lesson, that was the most enjoyable part. I actually got to do a lesson for one of my observations or evaluations, and I had small groups going and hands-on activities, and the kids they just took off with it and did amazing, and that was exciting because I not only got a good grade, but they got it, and which social studies is hard to teach because it is boring. and they actually had fun with that lesson, and so that was one of the more rewarding days, but definitely when they get it.
One was a couple weeks ago, my students were like, I learned something new today. I never knew that. And I was like, really? But I guess because I'm so much older than them, I was like, I figured it's like, everybody should know this, but they didn't know. And they were like, I learned something new today. And the other part is I implemented a flipped classroom project in which it was a whole week. I blocked off a whole week. And we went to the library, we went to the computer lab, and I had them do a project in groups on their own. They picked a topic from a pre-selected list. I was like, you can act it out, you can use computers, you can do whatever you want, but it has to be at least 5 minutes long. And it was just great because not only were the kids excited to research, but the librarian was like, I've never seen anybody use the library as much as you have, which was good and sad at the same time, in that I was a student teacher using the library when my colleagues prefer to use computer labs. And Fort Stockton, they have TextQuest, and it's a free computer database that they could use. And actually, the director of curriculum came up to me and said, thank you, because I was using the free resources the district provided for the students.
You know, when they get it, that feels really rewarding. But I also have to say the bonds that you create with the kids. I mean, I'm so attached to my kinder students especially, and now with my third graders, you know, every morning they're so excited to see you and hug you, and that's just, I almost cried when I left kinder. That's how attached I got.
I filmed some videos with my kids about science safety, and because my teacher and I were closing a unit about science safety, so we decided to do a PBL, and I filmed some videos with the kids, and I had a meeting with the school board, and it was awesome. It was great. And after that, the kids were like, oh, Mr. Tushy, what are we going to do now? They were so excited, and yeah.
I would have to agree with everyone. When they understand that concept, fifth grade, I found out that I really liked that grade, actually. I was really scared of going into fifth grade. I loved it, and I was scared of teaching social studies, and I actually love social studies. Like, now that I got to experience more with it. We did taxation without representation, and I was King George. I had like a little pamphlet, King George, and they were the colonists, and then I was taxing them, so I was like reading cards and taking their M&Ms away from them, and they were so excited. I loved it.
When that little light bulb goes off, it's just amazing. I covered a unit on, there's density, and that whole unit was me. And so it was towards the end of the unit, and then I stepped back and I told my teacher, I think they're ready. And so my teacher questioned them. And sure enough, hands kept going up, and they understood the material, and I was like, wow, they really got this. I really, you know, taught them something. So that was pretty fun. That was, I was taken back. I was like, I taught them density. So that was awesome. And that bond, fifth grade, gotta love fifth grade. I love fifth grade too. I think it's my deal. So it was towards the end of my fifth grade placement, and the kids were like, oh, Mr. Dixon, is this your last week? Is today your last day? And I was like, oh, maybe, I don't know. And I really didn't want to tell them. But then that Friday, or whatever day it was, pretty sure it was Friday, letters kept rolling in from them, like handwritten, like, hey, Mr. Dixon, here you go, here you go, here you go. And they were just saying goodbye and how awesome teacher I was. And I'm gonna treasure those letters for the rest of my life.
United the schools are, you know, the elementary, middle, and high. And you know, it's crazy because when I was in school in elementary, you did the Pledge of Allegiance in your own class, you know, all of that. And at Fort Davis, we do it all together every morning in the gym. We go to every single pep rally. Well, because if we don't, you see how empty it would be. But I love how united they are. And that school is amazing. If you decide to go to Fort Davis, the best decision I ever made, you know. They're so, all the teachers get along so well, the principal's amazing, and so, yeah, that was the biggest surprise for me, how united they were.
I learned that actually everything we have learned so far, we got to use it in student teaching. Like, to be honest, when we were in school, I was like, are we ever even gonna use this? We're learning this.
All the textbooks.
Yes, all the textbooks. And actually, I found myself going back to the textbooks and reading, and I was like, oh man, I wish I would have paid more attention on this. I have to read it again. So everything that you learn comes back and you need it.
Be ready. Like Charles said, the early mornings are hard. You're there till later than 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Chances are you're there at 7:30 in the morning. It's long days, but also it's rewarding. Get to know your students. That's how you become a great teacher. That differentiated instruction, that's real. And getting to know your students is how you make it possible. And so, don't be afraid to go in and, like, my first week when we're just supposed to be observing, I was in there helping out, and my teacher was like, that's amazing, you don't have to be asked to do anything. I was like, well, I'm a Sol Ross student, we're never asked to do anything. And so that's just, don't be afraid to do what your instincts are telling you, because we have been taught well. So go in and just do your best.
Be flexible. And just like Shelby said, get to know your students, because it's so much different from block two and block three, where block two, you just have your two lessons. And I know that maybe doing your first two lessons in a classroom was scary, but block three, you're doing it every day. And you can't let that get to you, because the students will pick up on that. So you have to be flexible enough to be like, okay, this isn't working out, let's try something new tomorrow. Or let's try something new the next period. Because if you don't have that flexibility, if you're set in your ways, you're not gonna do well. You need to be flexible. You need to be really flexible, and you need to know your students.
You need to get a lot of sleep right now. Because you're up early. I didn't get home sometimes till 6. And for a while there, I was working. And then you still gotta get home and lesson plan. So get a lot of rest right now. When you're at school, you don't feel it, because you're just up and going with all the kids. But once you get home, it hits you. But also, you have to have a lot of fun. You know, I do occasional dance breaks in my classroom, and that makes a difference. And so you just kind of have to have fun and just go with it. I really didn't try to stress it too much, you know. Everything you learn, like Diana says, it just hits you right then and there when you're actually up in front of the kids.
Stay organized. You have to.
You have to.
Expect the unexpected. Every day something new.
It's theory. You're not, you haven't applied anything up until student teaching. Once you get to student teaching, you're gonna apply most of it. Another thing is waking up early, get ready. I don't know if it was for y'all, but for me, definitely. I would just get home and I would just be trained. Just dead, just, I'm out. You're mentally exhausted, you're physically exhausted. It's gonna be a ride. It's tiring. Another thing is, the biggest one, don't be afraid to fail. There's just some times where you're just gonna do lecture and sometimes you're just not gonna feel it, and they're just gonna have that glazed over look, and then you're gonna question them, and it's gonna be, they didn't learn anything. And you have to step back, reassess, switch up the lesson, wake them up, and if you do that, if you just push yourself every day a little bit more, you know, look at yourself, see like, well, what can I do better? How can I, you know, get at this, you know, section different so that everybody can get it? Just, don't be afraid to fail and just keep pushing.